another toy recall to tell you about this morning.
Attorney Tom Kline is here to talk about that and what you should know before you buy your kids any toys. That and more on Good Day Returns. Let's get into that. Back to you. All right, thank you. Well, another toy recall to tell you about this morning, and lead is once again the culprit. The recall involves 350,000 gardening tools and chairs that are sold at Target. The CPSC says the toys tested positive for lead paint. Joining us live with some details on what's being done by the federal government to keep all of us safe is Attorney Tom Kline. Good morning. Thank you for coming in this morning.
Good morning, Chanel.
I have to tell you, I heard about this. I was reading about this morning. Another recall, lead paint. When is this going to end? I was listening to one of the radio spots this morning, and one expert says, you know, they think it's going to keep happening for now.
Oh, there's absolutely no end to it in sight. The problem appears to be right at the federal government's doorstep. The CPSC, and there was a major expose of this just recently, just has not been doing its job. It doesn't have adequate resources. It doesn't have adequate personnel. And we are just inundated with all kinds of products which just plain are not safe. It's not enough to say that China's the problem. It's not enough to say that industry is going to regulate itself. We need to have some strong regulation. Interestingly, industry, which now wants to protect itself against all of these Chinese imports, major corporations, major toy manufacturers are now saying, we need government regulation.
Hmm.
It's really a problem.
And we're showing video of toys, you know, and these aren't just, you know, kind of, I don't want to say random toys or toys that most kids don't have. This is from Target, you know, and we all know Target is just packed. And I should say, it's not just toys. We're hearing about other, you know, products as well coming from China. I heard, you know, you bought China, or you bought some, what'd you buy the other day? Dishes or something like that?
It is a true story. I purchased a new set of dishes for a new apartment.
Okay.
And I went to a very reputable realtor, and I brought them home, and underneath them, and it was my fault, I didn't look. I know I tell people to do it. I look, and it says made in China. And it has they're beautifully painted. And the first thing I thought, and I think consumers are thinking this way now, is this lead paint? Now, I happen to have the resources to go test it, because I'm curious. I'll come back and report, actually. But that's the problem. Just the other day, we had a toy recall right here locally. I'm sorry, a crib recall. 1 million cribs were recalled. Now, the issue is a little bit different there. The issue there is there's a design defect and poor instructions to consumers, but once again, that totally slips through the cracks. And here's the real problem. A lawyer, someone like myself who represented a family who lost a child in that crib, reports it to the government, to the Consumer Product Safety Commission.
Mm-hmm.
It takes 2 years, Chanel, 2 years for them now to recall after a lot of bickering and fighting. That's not protecting us.
Let's end with this. I'm out of time. The Consumer Product Safety Commission, they're going, you know, they were just in China to check the conditions there. Where do we go from here? I mean, would it be overreacting to check every single product to see whether it's from China and then just not buy it?
I think we should go to China. I think we should have a mission to China, a Fox 29. I'm willing to lead
it.
And we'll get to the bottom of it.
All right. Well, in other words, I guess in the meantime, people just have to do their homework.
You have to look and it's looking for obvious safety. But here's the problem, and I know we're out of time. When a crib has Winnie the Pooh on it, it tells you, buy me. And these are licensed figures, and the underlying product is not safe.
All righty. Well, Attorney Tom Kline, thank you for coming in, especially as the holiday season approaches. We'll have to be careful.
We have to be. Thanks, Chanel.